Yeah, so this is Cyber Shadow. It's a game that we're publishing at Yacht Club Games. We announced it a few days ago. And it's by a solo developer. He goes by Mechanical Head Studios. His name's Arne Hunziker.
So Yacht Club didn't develop this?
We did not. So we've been fans of Arne's his work, his art, and his game sensibilities for a long time. We've just been kind of mutual fans of each other. And we came to him saying, you know, we love your stuff. We'd love to publish and work with you. And, you know, at first he was hesitant. He didn't want to work with a publisher. And we kind of had to coax him into it, saying, you know, we have similar sensibilities as you. We'd love to help you kind of polish the design, help you with marketing and QA testing, and bring it to as many consoles as we can. And finally, you know, we kind of convinced him, and he was like, okay, you know, let's do this.
This looks like a fantastic match for Yacht Club. I own Shovel Knight. I own the Treasure Trove, in fact. I think I bought it 3 times just to support Yacht Club.
Yeah, yeah.
And this has so many aesthetic elements that just appeal to me in the same way.
That's great to hear. Yeah, it definitely appeals to our aesthetic sensibilities as well. So, yeah, I'd say we're on very similar wavelengths, and that's kind of why we decided to work with him. And so, we're very glad that he accepted.
Yeah, I imagine you are. He probably is now, too, looking how much publicity this is getting.
We hope so, yeah. We hope he's feeling happy and good about everything. We certainly are. So.
Could you spell his name for me, if you don't mind?
A-A-R-N-E. And then, we'll send you a press kit. You can
It's in there.
Yeah, it's in there.
Thank you.
That's an easier way to do it.
Okay, no problem.
Yeah.
I just want to make sure I have the name correct so that I can tell people who to go thank.
Sure, no worries.
When this hits retail.
Yep.
So, tell me a little bit mechanically about this game. How does it play? It reminds me a little bit of, it reminds me of a lot of things.
Sure. I mean, it draws inspiration from a bunch of different sources. Ninja Gaiden being kind of an obvious one.
You took the words right out of my mouth. Yeah.
So, I mean, visually, there's certainly, like, the ninja inspiration there.
There's some elements of Metroid here, it looks like.
Metroid, not as much. I mean, maybe aesthetically and thematically, but it's not a Metroidvania at all. It's definitely a fairly linear action platformer.
Okay.
Yep. There's influence from NES Batman games, and some enemies inspired by the Contra, classic Contra series.
Oh, I knew I saw something that reminded me of Contra.
Right, you got like those turrets on the wall.
Yeah, that's what it was.
Yeah.
So, and some Mega Man, it looks like, the spinny,
right.
Yeah, that...
Definitely some Mega Man influence, some Mega Man X inspired background work.
Oh, okay, yep, and is there a wall grab?
There is one. It's an upgrade later in the game.
Okay.
So in this game, you go through all the stages. You're trying to rescue your ninja clan that's been captured by rogue synthetic robots.
Okay.
And so as you rescue the ninjas, they kind of die and give you their powers, and those become the upgrades that you consume. And
I see.
The game kind of progresses from there as you become a more, you know, badass ninja with those cool new powers and abilities.
Excellent. The platforming looks pretty solid, too.
Arden has worked very hard to make it as smooth as possible, you know, so...
How long was this in development?
So, he's been working on the title for about 7 years, but this particular iteration for about 3.
Okay, and you said he's a solo developer?
Solo developer, other than the music, yeah. He does all the art, the programming.
So he's got a composer?
He's got a composer, yes.
Okay. That always, it inspires me so much to see these 1- and 2-person studios doing incredible stuff like this.
Oh yeah, it's hard work, for sure.
So what was Yacht Club's role with this? You said optimization?
Well, we're as publishers, we do a lot of QA testing for him. We help him kind of polish and hone the level designs at certain levels. And we're really just there as support for him because we enjoy his work so much, want to see him succeed and as many people as possible play it, right?
So you guys don't really involve yourselves in the creative process so much, just
right, we're not developing the game, right?
Okay.
Per se, yeah.
Well, I ask because sometimes even a publisher that's not directly involved may, like Activision with Sekiro, you know, they may provide other kinds of suggestions for ease of use and quality of life.
Sure.
That kind of thing.
So I would say we, at some level, we do kind of participate in that, and we have, you know, we're in very regular discussions with him about, you know, ease of use type stuff and polish. We have a lot of experience in that regard, so I think we're trying to like bring as much of that to him as possible.
Excellent.
This is his first, you know, solo major release.
That's incredible.
It's a daunting task, especially as a solo developer. So any way that we can help, we're trying to.
That's excellent. It sounds like he really found the right people. I've got nothing but respect for Yacht Club.
Thank you.
And, well, I mean, I'm familiar with the work that Yacht Club did with no pay for all that time on Shovel Knight. Like, I've heard that whole story.
Right.
And the fact that you guys were willing to do that is just, like, I want to do what I can to support you guys. And I know I'm a content creator, and I have not had a single viewer yet who has said anything but good things about Yacht Club.
Oh, that's very so, great to hear. Thank you.
You guys are on the right track, and I can tell you that a lot of people appreciate what you're doing.
Thank you so much.
Of course.
I appreciate you saying that. Yeah.
Well, I say it because it's true.